Assalamu alaikum everyone. I'm Dr. Aeman Naseer from the AccuFix Cosmetics team. And today, I'm going to tell you about what most dermatologists don't dare to tell their patients about acne medications. Before I proceed, a disclaimer. Every doctor is not the same, and everyone doesn't experience the same side effects of medications. That said, given the sheer number of horror stories that we've heard as a team, I do believe that it's my duty to share the information that follows so you can make an informed decision about whether or not you choose to use medications. When it comes to acne, three types of medications are typically prescribed: isotretinoin, also called Accutane, antibiotics, and hormone pills. What most people don't know about isotretinoin is that it is also a chemotherapy drug, and because it's so strong, it has an administration protocol. You can't be pregnant or be planning to get pregnant if you're planning to take the drug. In most countries, you're required to be taking contraceptives if you're planning to do a round of Accutane, since it can cause birth defects. You're also required to monitor your liver function and blood counts before you begin the medication, and every few weeks once you start, because of how it affects your body. We've had clients who've experienced hepatitis, severe dehydration, and anal fissures because of Accutane.
I took a 6-month course of isotretinoin, and it didn't end there. So basically, us waqt my skin became excellent. Bilkul koi matlab sab baith gaya, koi complaints nahi, koi acne nahi. Again, I self-medicated myself. Uske kuch mahine baad jab thoda sa wapas aaya, maine khud se leni shuru kar di ki acha iska ye solution hai. Not knowing or being aware that it actually has very serious side effects. It did come and hit me when I felt really ill in the US. I was on an exchange program, and wahan pe my liver was in a terrible state. And this is about maybe 3 years after I had finished that, or ye kahani purani hogi thi, and not me nor the doctors at that time could even relate to this ke ye iski wajah se hua hoga. But when I started reading up and knowing ke side effects iske kya ho sakte hain longer term, it was a really bad strain of jaundice that I had got, hepatitis A. It was really bad.
Like aapke 3 saal se persist kar raha tha.
Nahin, ye us waqt mujhe jaake hua hai, but basically something is taking a toll on you and making you weak, right? Yeah, yeah. And that build up, and it was just, I mean, my normal levels are supposed to be around, what, agar aapko ho bhi jaye, so maybe like 1200 ya something, ya us tarah. Main 9000, 8000 pe thi, mere jo uske levels the, like. And then it took time for that, so I had to come home and rest, and mera bahut difficult wo bhi time tha. I had to cut that exchange program short. I had to come back. I had to rest like 6 months. I couldn't really do much. So, ye tha.
And while these may be some of its less common side effects, they still occur in 10 to 30% of those taking the medicine. Among other things, those taking Accutane can also experience severe hair loss, decreased night vision, abnormal liver function, low blood counts, and increased blood sugar and cholesterol. It also has some more common side effects that are experienced by more than 30% of people. These include headaches, fever, sweating, pain in the bones, nausea and vomiting, severe dryness of the eyes, mouth and nose, and changes in eyesight. When it comes to acne, isotretinoin isn't the only scary drug. Other commonly prescribed drugs like hormones and antibiotics aren't without their challenges. I know of someone who developed intracranial hypertension, which is another name for pressure buildup in the brain, as a result of antibiotics, and had to undergo a type of surgery called lumbar puncture to relieve the pressure. Long-term antibiotic use also has other negative health effects. It alters the composition of your gut microbiome, which is essential for good health. Alterations in this are related to various diseases, including cardiovascular disease and cancer. They are also linked to increased risk of premature all-cause mortality. To keep this video from getting too long, I'm not going to get into how birth control works. What you should know, however, is that women taking oral contraceptives have a higher risk of heart attacks, strokes, and dangerous blood clots in their legs and lungs. They are also at a higher risk for high blood pressure, gallbladder disease, migraines, and depression. But maybe you're not concerned about all these side effects because you care more about getting rid of your acne permanently. But will that really happen? Here's why we don't think that it's worth putting your body through all of this for clear skin. For one, acne medications aren't a permanent cure for acne. In most cases, the acne returns after you stop taking the drug. This is true even if the drug in question is isotretinoin. A lot of people tend to relapse within 6 months to 2 years of completing a course of isotretinoin. Doctors typically put them on another course of the medicine, and the side effects are always worse the second time. Since no medication is without side effects, taking medicines for acne long-term is simply not sustainable and will destroy your overall health. More importantly though, acne can easily be managed simply by having a good skincare routine. A good way to understand the importance of skincare is just like this. Like the food you eat on a regular basis has an impact on your overall health, what you put on your skin has an impact on the health of your skin. Ingredients in skincare have an impact on the chemistry of your skin. This includes ingredients in products like cleansers that people usually don't pay much attention to. While skincare requires consistency and patience, which let's face it, so do drugs, and often also some hit and trial, it's still worth the investment since it has no side effects and is the only sustainable way to get great skin long term. Before I wind up this video, I'd like to end by answering one more question. And the answer to it isn't what you'd most probably expect. So who should you take skincare advice from? The answer is not your dermatologist. As a doctor, I can tell you that while dermatologists are taught the anatomy, physiology, and pathology of skin, they are not cosmetic formulators, nor is cosmetic formulation covered in medical school. Dermatologists who have solid skincare knowledge have it because they've done their own research. Most, however, simply use their medical degree as a reason for why they should be an authority on the subject, but that honestly doesn't mean anything. The skincare that dermatologists recommend typically consists of products that different pharmaceutical companies have pitched to them, not of products whose formulations and ingredients they've searched and understand the chemistry of. So who should you take skincare advice from? If you don't have access to a qualified aesthetician, do your own research. The internet has made all manner of information accessible to everyone. Find industry experts, make sure they're credible though. Since the internet also has a lot of misinformation and garbage, also take a hard look at your diet, lifestyle, and weight, since your diet, weight, and hormones are tightly intertwined. Focus on having a diet rich in fruits and vegetables with minimal processed food and animal products, and be sure to exercise regularly and you'll see a difference in your skin and even your overall health. If you want to learn more about how to fix your skin, I'm linking some blog posts and videos on how to build a skincare routine from scratch and on acne to get you started in the description box below. If you want to learn more about how to fix your skin, I'm linking some blog posts and videos on how to build a skincare routine from scratch and on acne to get you started in the description box below. However, if you don't want to put the requisite effort into reading or research, or perhaps you don't have the time to, don't worry, we've got you covered. Simply drop us a message on WhatsApp and we'll take care of the rest for you. Don't forget to like this video and drop your thoughts in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video, inshallah.